You can't come to Southeast Texas without at least thinking about them. So why not come to a place where you can see them and touch them? I'm talking about gators.
We are headed to Gator Country, a wildlife park with one specialty: alligators, lots of them. Admission is around 10 bucks and offers visitors the chance to get, well, as close as you'd ever want to. Jana Parr, one of the owners, was more than happy to talk to us in the middle of the gator pond.
I like to see how hungry they really are.
Yeah, I'm about to get closer than I ever wanted.
Don't trip.
So what's the likelihood that they would
about 60 in here
jump up or something?
They can.
Now, and I just pop them on the nose?
Here comes the big boy.
You come out here and do this. I don't know how these gators.
You're okay.
All right. Oh, that guy's a monster. How big is he?
Yeah, he's over 12. I'm going to get him to come up.
We're purposefully getting him to come up.
Come on, big boy. Oh, he's pissed.
Oh, what does that mean?
He's just mad.
He's mad at what? I have never had a 12-foot alligator mad at me, especially not one named Kong.
Okay, it makes me a little more comfortable to know she's putting her hand in the water about 2 feet from his mouth. You guys are just immune to being around alligators. What is this pond? Is this the big gators?
This is the large gator pond. These are all American alligators.
Which are native to Southeast Texas, obviously.
Right. A lot of these were rescued alligators.
That's right. There's more to Gator Country than just the park. The crew here is highly trained to capture gators and take them out of public areas. And just when I thought Jana was nuts for being out here, here comes Arlie.
They're crazy out here. This is insane.
While a gator is never something you'd want in your house, the ones around here seem sort of like pets in a weird reptile kind of way. And some are even trained. Meet Bruce, the jumping alligator.
Whoa. They fight.
And then the big daddy of the park, Big Al. Measuring over 13 feet long and weighing almost 1,000 pounds, Big Al is officially the largest captive gator in Texas.
He's been our largest attraction since we opened the park. Arlie, you're making me nervous. Unbelievable.
So this is even special for you.
It makes my heart when I hear that.
If we're making Jana, the owner of this place, nervous, that's something.
That's just powerful.
It takes a certain breed of man to make a profession out of wrestling gators. Some might call it courage, others stupidity. But whatever it is, Arlie's got it.
Don't try this at home has never been more important than this moment right here.
Neither has their slogan, quick hands or no hands, which is so crucial to remember, Arlie had it tattooed on his hands.
Not if you get bit, when you get bit, you have to go with it. You have to roll with them.
Okay.
Don't give them any resistance, they're gonna tear it off. I'm live bait. If I can get them to bite me, I can catch them. If you feel that sharp pain followed by a whole lot of pressure, he's caught. He done caught it. He took the bait. Now hold on. Go with it.
Gator Country isn't just about watching a man taunt death and educates its visitors on all things alligator, their habitat, their diet, their behaviors, and their elusive mating call. Which Arlie does so well, the gators actually think that he is a gator, trying to steal their alligator ladies. Visitors also get a chance to actually hold a baby alligator. It should be said that these guys are professionals. You should never approach a gator in the wild because it will eat you. These animals are incredible and deserve a great deal of respect. But I know what you're thinking. Yeah, gators are beautiful, but what do they taste like? Right. Well, Gator Country can educate you on that too.
You know, I couldn't come to Gator Country without eating some fried alligator. So I ordered this, some gator bites. This is chicken battered tail meat. And from what the cooks say, it's somewhere between a chicken tender and a chicken fried steak. Yeah, to use a cliche, it tastes like chicken. Kind of a little bit chewier, but it doesn't taste like pond water, and it doesn't taste like the bayou.
All right,
it's good. That's pretty good stuff.
If you liked this video, chances are you're gonna love another video that's somewhere right about here. Or you can visit thedaytripper.com. But above all, what I want you to do most, remember the Alamo. I'll see all y'all out on the road. Vaya con Dios, amigos.